Hello, I'm presenting on behalf of VirtualHealth, a growing startup that provides software as a service to healthcare insurance companies. But the problem we are presenting is not specific to healthcare. In many applications, transactional data became less relevant to daily operations with age. In contrast, as historical volumes grow, the data became more valuable for analytics. Here, we describe the relational data lake approach for storing daily, read-only snapshots of transactional databases. To lower the costs, we chose MariaDB ColumnStore because of its inherent data compression and Amazon Web Services S3 storage support. 10 years ago, James Dixon, founder and former CTO of Pentaho, came up with the data lake concept. A crucial data lake aspect is retaining the source data in its original form and format. I will elaborate more on the importance of this particular aspect later in the slides. Another problem we're addressing here is not unique to VirtualHealth. Operational systems in healthcare are complex and not directly suitable for analytics or machine learning algorithms. We chose to build the data pipeline to MariaDB ColumnStore since it already provides open source examples of integration with Jupyter Notebooks and Apache Zeppelin, popular open source tools used for data exploration and analytics. We present our data pipeline and share tips and tricks we have learned in the process. To conclude the introduction, I remind of a known problem of running analytical queries on the transactional database that can be slow and painful. To address this problem, a special storage format, columnar, can significantly improve performance of analytical queries. In this talk, we will focus on the MariaDB ColumnStore. We will show some representative use cases and demonstrate how MariaDB ColumnStore can be used for typical analytical queries. Why some queries are slow in transactional databases? Let us find top 10 clients who visited doctors most often. Such ranking queries are known to be hard for relational database technologies. Thus, it is not surprising that this query is so slow. As a side note, please take a look at the locations column highlighted on this slide. Why we are so interested in visit locations? This is just one example how our software reduces healthcare costs by enabling booking multiple doctor's appointments in one location. Coming back to the query speedup, what about indexing? This query is already using index, as shown on the query explained plan. What about additional index? Indeed, adding covered index does help. But the query is still slow, particularly for user interface, when users tend to reload the web page when the query is so slow, which in turn overloads the database with repeated slow queries. But the first ranking query example was only the beginning. How about the second ranking query, identifying high-value clients? Please note that multiple table joins are not uncommon when the schema is highly normalized for transactional performance. You must be truly patient to get the result. It took over 9 hours to learn that some clients experienced the most expensive treatment. As a homework, you may do your own web search to learn more about it. Let me summarize why our analytical queries were slow in the transactional environment. This is because most relational databases, such as MariaDB, are row-oriented. If query needs two columns, it will read the whole row. InnoDB organizes tables by pages, resulting in even more data to be read in. And the last but not least, MariaDB will use only one CPU core per query. In case of our first ranking query, the row-oriented database have to read the whole row to get the data for just 3 columns, as shown on this slide. In contrast, the column-oriented databases read only the data from the 3 columns involved in the query. Now, let me present the results of our comparison of the InnoDB versus ColumnStore. The comparison was done using two different EC2 instances, small and very large. And let me describe here our first tip regarding the ColumnStore that happens to have 2 installation options. The single node, not distributed option, is useful for initial evaluation, but it is not expandable, which is often overlooked. This explains why we started with the distributed installation on the single node, which may look confusing, but is unavoidable if you plan to add more nodes in the future. What about the first ranking query? There is no large difference, since the added covered index is essentially an equivalent of the column store, reading data from just 3 columns. However, our conclusion is that the column store is preferable, since you cannot add covered indices for all of your analytical queries. What about the very large query? Let us find out. Well, this query is indeed challenging. The extra tuning is necessary. The solution is to allow the disk-based joins. After the column store restart, we are ready to try again, and wow! Even with disk-based joins, the column store performance is more than 2 orders of magnitude faster. The performance can be improved further when the joins fit in memory. Another column store benefit is a reduced storage. In our case, we observed an overall factor of 4. Half of that is due to a compression. We have a lot of binary encrypted protected health information data that are not expected to compress well. And another half is from indices removal. For the lack of time, I refer to other column store presentations to learn about this feature in more details. With such an impressive performance gain, we clearly need to transfer data to the column store. But how? What about the traditional extract, transform, and load approach? Since MariaDB ColumnStore has a built-in transactional engine, we use an asynchronous replication slave as our data staging area. As I said before, the crucial data lake aspect is to minimize data transformation to retain its original format. For data load, we take advantage of two built-in InnoDB and ColumnStore engines and use a simple but elegant approach. Stop replication, load data using in parallel the internal, very efficient binary data transfer, then resume the replication. In our approach, we essentially implemented the so-called ELT, not the traditional ETL. This is in line with the general shift towards ELT. The shift is enabled by an increased computing power and capabilities provided by the cloud. In practice, one must transfer the database schema as a first step. In a first approximation, it is rather simple. You just replace engine InnoDB with ColumnStore. However, this doesn't work out of the box. This slide lists certain steps you need to take to eliminate DDL differences, such as the absence of explicit indices in the column store. Also, some data types are not supported. We used the replacements listed on this slide. Here are some other differences that we encountered. Some of these are legacy and not needed in the original schema. Also, virtual columns are not supported. We expect that since virtual columns has no additional data, they can simply be omitted. But those differences were rather trivial. Here we need to dive deeper as it relates to subtle differences in the known issue with null values versus empty strings for certain string data types. As documented, implicit value for string types is an empty string. Here we are converting the schema to column store as is. But then, as documented, the column store treats a zero-length string as a null value. As a result of these features, during data transfer, you will get an error, as shown on the slide. To resolve this issue, more schema tweaking is needed. You may need to remove not null for columns for all strings data types. As you may expect, the list of reserved words is different, which creates some extra issues. For those schemas that have the table user, like in MySQL user, a recent example of such schema was presented at the MariaDB webinar. As we iterated over the schema conversion, we found that Docker images are very helpful in this process. Now to the most advanced part of the presentation, data import. Here are more technical details about the approach. As documented, it is using very efficient binary data transfers behind the scenes. In certain cases, you may need to execute such command lines yourself, as we described in the next slide. This is because the internal approach may not work for you as it provides no interface to control the separator, such as in cases of data having the backslash character. To debug such failures, please take a look at the error files generated in your data directory. For those cases, we used the command line as described on the slide. Also, we had to switch to the command line to increase the read buffer, as shown on this slide. Here is another case to use the command line to preserve the original data values. Since by default the column store will replace null values with zeros for the nullable integer or date and time columns. Also, for the very large tables, you may encounter the error shown on the slide. In that case, you just need to tune configuration further as described. Fortunately, this could be done online. And the last but not least advice is to disable the binary login during data transfer. Otherwise, you would accumulate huge binary log volumes during data import. To conclude, let me clarify first that on the numerous issues we described in our previous slides, please do not get the wrong impression that column store is some kind of an emerging product with associated issues. On the contrary, the successful load of healthcare data to the column store is attesting to its level of maturity. The healthcare records are notoriously complex. You may get a preview of this complexity by looking at a couple of open source electronic health record projects that have about 200 tables each. The virtual health database schema is on par with more comprehensive commercial electronic health record systems that have 3 times as much more tables and thousands of columns. Summarizing, let me conclude that the relational data lake built with MariaDB ColumnStore retains the source data in their original format. We observed analytical query speedup of more than 2 orders of magnitude, and the native MariaDB protocol lowers application integration barriers. Thus, we look forward to evaluate the latest MariaDB community server version that includes the column store plugin with S3 storage support. Also, the data lake approach looks attractive for data archival. Here, data lake retention of the original schema simplifies application data access. Thank you for your attention. Any questions?